Get ready to match the stars. Richard Kiel. Rex Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Mary Ann Mobley. Paul Wiggins. And Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded big money match game. And now, here's the star of match game, Gene Rivers.
Oh, we. Hello there. Thank you all. Thank you, Jim. How do you do?
Ask. Go ahead, ask.
Well, it certainly is elegant with all of those.
Oh, I love the gold.
That's beautiful.
Want to
yeah.
hear the long, long story that goes with it?
Yeah, of
Or the abbreviated version.
Right.
I have yesterday, on yesterday's show,
yes.
we had a policeman. And
right.
I said that I was, you know, a friend of the police. I have a friend who is, this is Rogers, Arkansas. And my friend Chuck Gorley is the chief of police
One
in Rogers, Arkansas.
Yeah.
And he gave me this, which is a SWAT team hat. For having 20 highway patrolmen getting a beef during my show.
That's a true story.
True.
Well,
what was it worth all that?
20 highway patrolmen.
20 highway patrolmen flailing.
Got angry with each other?
They were fighting each other.
Yeah, they were eating each other's arms and feet. Biting noses and ears off.
Wow.
And what did I do?
What?
Keep singing. And yes, we've just begun.
Come on down here, Elaine. All right. Take your spot there on the little blue dot. We'll wheel this thing around here for you and let you have a go at the big money. She won the game at the end of yesterday's program, and that means she's entitled to a shot at the super match here, where you could win over $10,000. Good luck to you.
Wouldn't that be nice?
That would be wonderful. We could go out in the town and have a terrific time.
Okay.
Is that okay? All right. Here we go. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank Brat. $500 for matching the most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Whom do you want?
Marcia.
I get so little recognition now that I'm out of showbiz. I like to get involved in the super matches. Spoiled Brat?
Spoiled Brat. Okay. There's one.
A very boring answer, Little Brat.
Little Brat, there's his. One more.
No influence. Paul.
Been one for years. Spoiled Brat.
Well, we already did that one, darling.
Brett.
Oh, you forgot to mention the chief of police from Rogers was hard of hearing.
What was the first one?
Spoiled Brat was the first one.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear that. I mean, I was thinking about my career, and it was really upset.
Right.
Rotten Brat.
Spoiled Brat, Little Brat are the three they've given you. You choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
I'll choose Spoiled.
Yeah. Spoiled Brat. Let's see if they have a spoiled brat anywhere up there. We'll begin by revealing the $100 response. Subaru Brat is the name of an automobile, a four-wheel drive. Four-wheel drive car.
That's Japanese for spoiled.
Oh, Gene,
right.
You're so...
Subaru Brat, a very mean car. All right, let's take a look at the next one. Little Brat is up there. They gave you that one, so it looks very likely that spoiled brat will be up there for you. Here we go. Yes, it is. Congratulations. All right. You got the $500. That means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. However, you are going to spin the wheel. And if you get a lucky spin of the wheel, you'll double it and play for $10,000. Get up there and have a go at it. Just grab that peg up there and give it a pull, and away we go. We're all going to root for a double now. Well, you know, they get to spinning so slow when they get up there, you think, oh, it stopped on the star, and then everybody's... Oh.
I hate the responsibility.
Yes. Well, anyway, here you go.
Dirty job, but somebody's got to do it.
That's my day
right.
in the barrel.
It's worth $5,000. Here we go. Good luck to you. Blank cuffs.
blank cuffs, C-U-F-F-S. Okay. Elaine, you give us the answer.
Excuse me. Excuse me.
No, that's right.
What was the spelling of the word, please?
C-U-F-F-S.
Oh, thank
you. All right. Here we go. Blank cuffs. What do you say to that?
All I can think of is shirt cuffs.
What are you going to do? What can I say?
It's a bummer, yeah.
I don't think you're going to get the money.
For 2 million?
No.
Cruel. Sure. God, you're cruel sometimes.
Mary Ann, what do you got there?
First thing I thought of was French cuffs.
French cuffs?
I'm sorry.
I would have blown the whole thing.
Handcuffs. That's the male answer, you see. That's the male. This is the female answer.
Puffs.
You thought I said puffs?
But, honey,
you and the sheriff really ought to get together more often.
Can we get a doctor in here to check my ear? I need a haircut is what I need.
All right. Now, we're going to play one more game, so let's get Tony back here for the second and final game. Come on back, Tony. Oh. Tony, what'd you do backstage?
Watched her.
Oh, you watched her. Oh, all right. Well, then you know how it goes because you've played one game. Tony Menendi, remember, is our policeman here who lives, where do you live again?
Newhall.
Newhall. You work in the Venice area.
Yeah.
And is it interesting there? Do you have any problems with roller skaters or bike riders on that path?
That's all we have trouble with. Not
really?
All we have trouble with.
Do they
That's
fight each other because...
They fight each other for the bike path.
They do.
And we referee.
You do?
Yes.
Do a grand job. Tony, A or B?
B, please.
B it is. Yeah. Bernie is the world's greatest salesman.
Uh-oh.
He could sell the head of the Ku Klux Klan a vacation in blank.
dangerous question.
All right, Tony. Bernie is the world's greatest salesman. He could sell the head of the Ku Klux Klan a vacation in blank.
Africa?
Africa. He saved Africa. What do you say?
Well, this is pretty close. Nigeria.
Nigeria. That's a match.
Any of you Ku Klux Klanners want to write me a letter, I'll be glad to burn a white cross on your lawn. Harlem.
Harlem. Africa and Harlem are two good responses.
People have been asking me about my hat. My hat is a
gift.
Yes,
now what about that hat,
it's
sir?
It's a gift from the
you.
Lieutenant of the police of...
Puerto Vallarta?
No. It's from Lieutenant
Acapulco.
Emmanuel Suez from East Guadalajara.
East Guadalajara.
And since that laid a bomb, I better come up with the right answer. Johannesburg, South Africa.
All right. So there's another one for Tony. Miss Marianne?
Yes, sir?
What do you got for us?
Well, this is a place I lived for a year and loved it. Africa.
Oh, yeah, you did a series there.
Born free.
Unlike Brett, I am easily intimidated by people who run around in sheets and burn things on your lawn.
Africa. Another one for Tony.
Good thing you got.
Marcia.
Good
Marcia.
For the short kid. If they bother you, hon, you just call me.
I'm as good as dead. Hey, say goodbye to the boy singer.
No.
Why should they not be against
Richard's
you? They're against
your side.
Everybody else.
You got Richard. He'll stand up.
We stand up, America, and say,
right.
We don't
there
like
goes.
You. Triple K, why don't you come out on this subject? You haven't said what you think of that organization. Man. Come on, give.
I think they stink.
Could be you.
There.
I'm with you. They give
Hello.
Themselves
oh,
a
I
bad
love it
name.
When you get fierce. Makes me crazy. See, we're smarter than we look, this group.
Oh, very good. 5 for him. 5 for him. And you got a little catching up to do. First, we have this for you.
Where's my CCW? I've got the ray gun now.
I know. In San Diego.
All right. We're back on the air, folks.
So we'll get...
Oh!
All right. The social session is over. Here we go. Back to work. In his apartment,
Hank said, same time as usual, Motel 6.
Hank said, he's in his apartment, Hank said, there's too much noise. Either the people upstairs are playing punk rock or they dropped their kid into the blank. He's complaining about the noise in the apartment, you see.
Here I'm giving a demonstration, not getting any attention.
People just don't pay.
You mean you can't have a demonstration on television anymore?
I smell burning.
No,
flesh.
Nothing is burning because I work with the Coast Guard and I know how to put it out.
All right.
Women and children first.
Here we go.
But you got to get a new rug now back here. But
did you burn your answer or did you put it as a slot?
Oh, is the game on?
Yes.
What's it called?
We're on the air.
Go ahead. Polizia.
Polizia.
Right. In his apartment, Hank said, there's too much noise. Either the people upstairs are playing punk rock, or they drop their kid into the blank.
Garbage disposal.
Isn't that terrible? That's close.
I would imagine the child would object to that.
Boy, oh boy.
Yeah, oh.
That's worse than punk rock.
Right. Oh, it's a revolting thought, isn't it?
It really is. That's, yes. That's sick.
Thanks.
Yeah, I have four little children.
Yeah.
The idea of putting them in the garbage disposal.
Now, I have big hands. Oh, boy. Do your Christmas shopping early for this guy.
Yeah.
All right. What do you
say? They call him old one shot. I wasn't quite as sadistic, although I have children. There have been days. I said the toilet bowl and all that flush.
Right. A lot of noise there.
So tasteful.
Because I wasn't paying attention, I was more concerned about my demonstration. I copied the answer toilet bowl.
Oh, all right. This is candid confession time. All right, Marianne. Either people upstairs are playing punk rock or they drop the kid into the...
The little one got so dirty, she put it in the washing machine.
The washing machine. Just tumble them around a little bit.
Oh, I'm a very mixed up guy because my folks used to put me in the blender.
Oh. Oh, that's how you got short.
My whole hands?
Okay.
Yeah,
you like that, don't you?
Yeah.
Something about that.
Look at that.
Wait a minute. No, not cheating. Look at that. Quiet. Boy, those hands are white.
Yes.
Now, are those hands white?
They are white hands. White hands, I love. Hello, Marcia.
Probably the most fun I've ever had. Hard to believe, isn't it? Oh, my God, it's the song cue.
Would Dick and Tino please come by and leave? We found the other half of your...
Play something.
All right, it's one of my favorite tunes. Kid in Blender by Dickie Doo and the Don'ts.
All right. 5-1 the score. We go to round two here. Since you're ahead, Tony, you go first.
B again, please.
B it is. One person plays. It's you, Brett.
Oh, good gravy.
Ron said, I knew my date last night was going to be really wild when she got into the car and she was wearing blank.
Oh, okay. That was good to me.
Not easy.
Nice celebration, but a lot of invitations are lost in the mail.
Ron said, I knew my date last night was going to be really wild when she got into the car and she was wearing blank.
A loincloth?
A loincloth. Why would she be doing that, Tony?
It's wild.
Oh, wild. You're thinking of Africa and loincloths and Tarzan and Cheetah and that kind of wildness.
I think deep.
We're
Let's
thinking
not
of a different...
Jane.
Yes, Jane. We're thinking of a different kind of wildness, weren't we?
Sure, and I remember one night when you came to pick me up.
No, quiet. I'm with the game. I'm with the game.
And you said, what are you wearing? And I said, nothing.
Oh. Eileen, you need 4-5 Ruth said, no wonder my husband is walking funny. For Father's Day, the kids gave him paper mache blanks. No wonder my husband is walking funny. For Father's Day, the kids gave him paper mache blanks.
Underwear.
Underwear? All right, he said paper mache underwear.
Boy, with what I'm doing, I'm going to stay out of Venice if he's up there. I'm going to mind my manners. I said shorts.
Shorts. All right, one for her. Score is now 5-2. Chuck?
Shorts.
All right. Score is 5-3. Marianne?
Boy, did he stand up straight. Shorts.
5-4. Paul?
You understand this is not a word I enjoy writing. Shorts.
Shorts. 5-5. A tie game.
But I'm under no pressure.
No, not at all.
I've aged quickly in this spot.
But it doesn't show.
Oh, thank you so much. A little slow on the uptake, but I didn't want to write short sitting next to the short kid, see? I thought I'd take it personal, so I wrote choose.
Shoes.
Ooh. Oh, boy, another tiebreaker.
Ooh. So the game ends in a tie, and we'll get to that right after we do this for you. All right. Now we go to the tiebreaker. Turn these lights off first here. Push the button, reveal one tie-breaking question for each. The one who matches the most will be the winner. Tony, A or B?
A this time, Gene.
A this time, he said. A.
Oh, it's his first A.
Which is his first A. Gloria never does anything right. The day before her wedding, Gloria lost her blank. Never does anything right. The day before her wedding, Gloria lost her blank.
Virginity.
Gene?
Yes, ma'am?
What's that?
You remember back in the third grade?
Yeah. In the third grade, you remember. Yes. You remember. How it was in the third grade, how it used to be, yes. Hello.
I thought that was a thing of the past, but I put fiancé.
Fiancé.
Yeah.
All right. That's a good answer. Fiancé, virginity are both good answers.
Well,
what do you say?
Of course they are, but it wasn't so bad, but it was with an old friend. It wasn't with the groom. That's what made it bad. Anyway, no, Tony, we finally got there. Innocent.
There it is. One for Tony. Let's make it two for Tony.
It's two for Tony. Virtue.
Virtue. That's two for Tony. All right, Marianne, make it three for Tony.
Tony, I think yours was a wonderful answer. However, I thought of husband-to-be.
Husband-to-be is hers answer. All right.
All right. All right. Think you've got a decent boo in you? Let's hear it. I couldn't say virginity because I'm not that kind of kid. I said dress. Boo.
You got that out of your system. Yes.
I could play the love theme from the movie Berserk.
Sure.
Oh, Tony, I love that Tony, but I can't help him.
Droom. So Tony picks up two.
Well, I'm not crazy about you guys.
Marlene, you'll need two to tie and three to win. The ringmaster at the circus said, this morning, I got up on the wrong side of the bed. It was a big mistake. You see, I sleep next to the blank. Circus said this morning and got up on the wrong side of the bed. It was a big mistake. You see, I sleep next to the blank.
Here's one of my bummers again. Lions.
Lions. All right. She said lions, Richard.
Well, that'd be a terrible place to wake up next to a lion.
That would be a terrible place to wake up.
They're in the same general area. Tiger.
Tiger. Charles.
Lion's Den.
Lion's Den. Presumably there were lions in the Lion's Den. Marianne?
Well, I also thought of the lions.
That wins the game.
What do you have, Paul?
Elephant. Come on down.
What do you have for the lions?
give the change.
And you got it, you would please. Tony, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure being here.
Going to send some gifts to you from Nat's game. Tony Menenti, ladies and gentlemen. There he goes. Now we're going to send a message for America and then hurry back and see how much money she wins. Gene, you ever know what next time you're ready for that? Thank you. Bye.
Some contestants will receive from Kinney a great selection of great American shoe styles. Kinney's got the look you want, America. That's why Kinney is a great American shoe store. And Bowl of Beauty Real Roses, specially treated to keep their natural beauty for years. The ideal gift anytime at florists and better stores now. And Good Air CA90, a collagenizer, recirculating air cleaner, deodorizer, removes tobacco smoke, odors, dust, pollen continuously, keeps the air you breathe fresher, cleaner. And the Cherrywood collection from Echo. Kitchen tools with genuine Cherrywood handles, shaped for better grip and control, work as beautiful as they look. And a tray of O'Henry Delicious Penis, chewy caramel and fudge covered with chocolatey goodness. If you're wild about penis, you'll be nuts about O'Henry. And a baking dish and cream mess, the macaroni and spaghetti in the famous green box. Cooks up tender without sticking together. And a calculator and Pledge gives your furniture a clean, clear, more beautiful shine. Pledge brings out the beauty every time you dust. Speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program is edited for Boston.